Dear viewers of the Tom Photo channel, when switching between cameras with different sensor sizes like the full-frame Nikon D610 and the crop sensor Nikon D3400, you notice that the same lens behaves differently on each camera. This is because the size of the sensor affects both the angle of view, which is how much of the scene you capture, and the depth of field, which is how much of the image is in focus. In this video, I'll walk you through how to match both the angle of view and depth of field between two different cameras. Let's start with the Nikon D3400, which has a crop sensor. It's also called an APS-C sensor. The lens in this example is set at 35mm with an f-stop of 3.5. If you switch to a full-frame camera like the Nikon D610 and want to get the same angle of view and same depth of field in your shot, you'll need to adjust both the focal length and the aperture of the lens on the D610. This happens because crop sensors, like the one on the D3400, are smaller than full-frame sensors. The D3400 has a crop factor of 1.5, which means that the sensor crops the image compared to the full-frame camera. Crop factor is simply the ratio of the diagonals of the two sensors. These are the dimensions of the full-frame and crop sensor. From this, we can calculate the diagonals of these sensors. Once we know the diagonals, we simply divide the two diagonals to get the crop factor. The crop factor affects both the focal length, how zoomed in the image appears, and the depth of field. Let's first match the angle of view. The angle of view refers to how much of the scene the camera captures. A crop sensor camera makes this lens behave as if it has a longer focal length compared to the full-frame camera. To match the angle of view between the D3400 and D610, we need to adjust the focal length of the full-frame camera. Here's how you do that. To find the equivalent focal length for the full-frame Nikon D610, we multiply the crop sensor focal length by the crop factor. As simple as that. So the Nikon D3400 has a 35mm lens in this scenario, and the crop factor is 1.5. So the full-frame equivalent focal length is 35mm multiplied by 1.5, which is 52.5mm. This means that on the Nikon D610, you would need a lens set to around 50mm to catch the angle of view that you get with a 35mm lens on the D3400. Next, let's move on to the depth of field, which refers to how much of the image is in focus. A shallow depth of field means that only a small portion of the image is sharp, while a deep depth of field means more of the scene is in focus. Depth of field is affected by three factors: focal length, aperture, and sensor size. Since the full-frame sensor on the Nikon D610 is larger, it naturally gives a shallower depth of field compared to the crop sensor on the Nikon D3400, even when using the same aperture. To match the depth of field, you need to stop down or close the aperture on the full-frame Nikon D610. You can calculate the equivalent aperture for the full-frame camera by simply multiplying the crop sensor aperture by the crop factor. In this case, the D3500 is set at f-stop 3.5, so the full-frame equivalent aperture would be 3.5 multiplied by 1.5, which is 5.25. To keep things simple, we'll round this to f5.6. So, to get the same depth of field on the Nikon D610, you'll need to set the aperture to f5.6. This will give you the same amount of focus from front to back as the D3400's f3.5 setting. Thanks so much for watching. If you consider subscribing to my channel or leaving a like, I'll be very happy. See you again soon. Goodbye.